It's the late 1990s, going into the early 2000s. The only current models that Midland had at the time were the 74210, which is, where the fuck is it? Right there. And the 74200. They were still selling the 74109 M105 at the time. They were starting to become outdated. The 1050Hz technology was going away. And same introduction was just now coming into the market of weather bands, AM, FM bands, along with their gray boxes and other equipment. Did you do that?
Nope.
Wow. What a coincidence with that. But anyways, the year is 2001, and Midland decides to come up with a new product in their market of weather radios. So, the version 1 WR100, 2001. The version... Huh? Good!
Wait, what?
Anyways. Back to what I was saying. The Midland WR100 version 1. 2001. The Midland WR100 version 2. 2003. The Midland WR100 version 3. 2004. The Midland WR100 version 4, 2007. The Midland WR100 version 5, 2009. And finally, the new version 5, or actually rumored version 6, 2011. The last year for the WR100s. You're probably wondering, why do I have all six of Nicholas's 100s out here? That's because in this episode of Radio Reviews, we are going to be taking a look at every single Midland WR100 version ever. From 2001 to 2011, starting off with the beloved black and silver right up here. So, let's start from scratch and review these bad boys. Isn't that the most beautiful sight you have ever seen? Anyways, all six of these WR100s are going to be reviewed today, each for the same reason. We're going to compare each and every one of them to each other. We're going to discuss the features on every one. This is one huge comparison video bundled into a radio reviews episode. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the first feature. But not before discussing this radio's iconic design and reputation that this has. So let's go ahead and start from the top. It all started right here with the black and silver WR100. This came out in, like I said, 2001. Then it started here with the version 2. Then the version 3, then the 4, then the 5, and then the version 5 Ultra, as I like to call it, because it's like the latest V5, or the famed V6. If you don't believe me, ask Matthew English. Apparently, His grandmother, if I am correct, had a version 6, but we never saw it. Anyway, if Midland made a version 8 WR300, then I can probably suspect that they made a V6100, but anyways, we'll get to that in a minute. First off, we're going to discuss this radio's most iconic sound first. The Siren Test. Now, with the versions 1 and 2, you cannot do a Siren Test on it. But if you want to hear the Siren Test on those two radios, there's a link in the description. Or actually, just the version 1, but whatever. Version 2 is the same thing, but anyways. You can do it on the version 3 and over, because the version 3 introduced a bunch of new features with it, including a Siren Test. So let's start with the V3 first. Alert test. Probably the most iconic sounding siren in the history of weather radios. And then you have the version 4. By the way, before you ask, this isn't actually a version 4. This is actually NorCalDude 599's old version 5 that he gave to Nicholas. But the version 4 and the version 5 are basically the same radios. So, no harm, no foul. So, and if you do all 4,
orgasm.
Do you have your proof?
Yes.
Where's your proof?
On video.
Evidence is doctored.
No, bullshit! Pretty sure what you said was so fucking loud, Ellie will be able to hear it from miles away while you fucked her in her exhaust pipe.
Bitch.
By the way, this is Thunder Buddy 01.
Yeah, I'm currently rearranging my radios. Don't worry, I'm not giving up EAS for all you think. I'm actually deciding to rearrange my radios for the first time in a while.
Yeah, so before any of you fuckers jump to conclusions, you fucking kids, let's not. Anyways, back to the review. So we heard the siren test at, hey! Lit. Anyways, so we heard the siren tests on the version 3, 4, 5, and other version 5. Well, actually, there's 3, 4, there's actually 3 5s in here, but like I said, version 4 and version 5 WR100s are basically the same fucking thing! But, but yeah, that has to be the most iconic siren in the history of weather radios, as I've said already. So, let's go ahead and get down to the next feature, and that would be the button beeps. Now, unlike the siren test, you can actually hear the button beeps on every single version! Whee! Anyways, the version 1 and the 2 button beeps sound different, because I guess they had some older firmware. But anyway, here's the version 1, first off. Version 2. It's not really supposed to sound like that, but the speaker is kind of busted on the V2. But it still works.
Till 5 p.m. Sunday at 8:47.
Anyways. Version 3. So you notice with the version 3 and over, the button beeps have like those clicky sounds on the beginning of the end of the beeps. So let me just go ahead and demonstrate that. Here's the V1.
Version 3. Slightly different beeps. And this applies to all versions above version 3. Like version 3 and above. It has the same exact button beeps, as we'll now demonstrate on the three V5s, but I'm just gonna call this a V4.
Just cause I feel like it!
V5. And here's the last V5. Yeah, those are the iconic sounding button beeps on each WR100. So let's go ahead and get into the next feature on it, and that would be the speaker quality. Okay, speaker quality on the version 1s through 5s WR100s. Okay, let's start off with the version 1. Now, I should mention that the tuner on the V1 is going slightly wonky, but it's not dying. So before any of you guys say,
"Oh no, the fucking tuner's dying, it's at the end of the fucking water, we know it!"
No. It fucking works still, otherwise it would not be here in this goddamn review. So anyways, let's listen to the V1. There's the V1. And yes, it said please check with your authorities for local beach closures because of COVID! But, anyways, here's the V2.
Weather, mostly sunny. Areas of dense fog in the morning. High temperature, low 80s.
I already mentioned that the speaker on the V2 is kind of busted, but usually it sounds very bassy and thick. Giggity. Kind of like the version 1.
Low at 12:34 p.m. Sunrise, 5:33.
Like, it usually sounds like that.
From Monday, rip current risk, moderate. Surf heights, 2 to 3 feet. Thunderstorm potential, low. Little chance of thunderstorms. Weather, mostly sunny. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. High temperature, mid-80s. Max heat index, upper 90s. Winds, southwest winds 10 to 15.
Alright, V3.
1 a.m. Low at 1:23 p.m. Sunrise, 5:34 a.m. Sunset, 8:15 p.m. For Tuesday, sunny. Highs lower 80s. Northwest winds around 5 miles per hour. For Wednesday, partly sunny. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Highs upper 70s. Southeast winds around 5 miles per hour. And for Thursday, partly sunny. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Highs upper 70s. Southwest winds around 10 miles per hour. And rip current risk categories. Low risk implies that wind and wave conditions do not support an enhanced rip current risk. However, life-threatening rip currents are always possible in the vicinity of groynes, jetties, reefs, and piers. Moderate risk. Life-threatening rip currents are possible in the surf zone.
Version 4.
Check with local beach patrols first. Be sure to swim within sight of a lifeguard and never alone or at night. High risk. Life-threatening rip currents are likely for all people entering the surf zone. Anyone visiting the beaches should stay out of the surf. If you enter the surf zone, always have a flotation device with you and swim near a lifeguard. If caught in a rip current, relax and float, and do not swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and yell or wave for help. For UV index definitions plus more on rip current and beach safety, see https://www.weather.gov/beach/. OKX. For the following area, in Connecticut, southern New London, heat advisory in effect until 8 p.m. Monday. What? Heat index values up to 99.
Oh, go the fucking heat!
Anyways, the version 5.
High temperatures and high humidity may cause heat illnesses to occur. Drink plenty of fluids, stay in an air-conditioned room, stay out of the sunday.
Bet!
On relatives and neighbors. Young children and pets should never be left unattended in vehicles under any circumstances. Take extra precautions if you work or spend time outside. When possible, reschedule strenuous activities to early morning or evening. Know the signs and symptoms of heat exhaustion and heat stroke. Wear lightweight and loose-fitting clothing when possible. To reduce risk during outdoor work, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration recommends scheduling frequent rest breaks in shaded or air-conditioned environments. Anyone overcome by heat should be moved to a cool and shaded location. Heat stroke is an emergency. Call 911. For the following area.
Now for the version 5, new version at least, the newer version 5.
Northern Fairfield, Northern New Haven, Northern Middlesex, and Northern New London, and the following areas, in New Jersey, Western Passaic, Eastern Passaic, Hudson, Western Bergen, Eastern Bergen, Western Essex, Eastern Essex, Western Union, and Eastern Union, and the following areas, in New York, Orange, Putnam, Rockland, Northern Westchester, Southern Westchester, Northwest Suffolk, Southwest Suffolk, Northern Nassau, Southern Nassau, and Northeast Suffolk. Heat advisory remains in effect until 8 p.m. Monday. What? Heat index values up to 102. Where? Portions of Northeast New Jersey, Southern Connecticut, and Southeast New York. When? Until 8 p.m. Monday. Impacts. High temperatures and high humidity may cause heat illnesses to occur. Drink plenty of fluids. Stay in an air-conditioned room. Stay out of the sunday.
Cunt!
Alexa, how hot is it going to be today?
Today, expect a high of 94 degrees Fahrenheit.
Oh, fuck that!
Wait, what did it say?
94. High of 94.
Yeah, it's 93 right now.
Wait, is it?
Yeah.
Hang on, mine says 92, but I'm gonna believe Nicholas because Apple is more accurate, so.
Oh, fuck me!
But, anyways.
Not
gay, but thanks. I wasn't talking to you! Nicholas. And holy shit on a fucking cracker with fucking.
Yeah, when I said I was rearranging, I was not kidding.
No shit.
Now I just gotta take care of the lovely fire hazard underneath my bed and over here.
Let's take a good look at it.
Holy fuck.
Hold on, let me shine a flashlight.
Holy fuck. It's worse than mine.
And over here, I'm sure every firefighter ever would probably scream at me.
Yeah, I would fucking say so myself.
So, yeah, now I just gotta decide where the, I just gotta take all the cords out and just, decide where I'm gonna put, where I'm gonna put these radios.
There's the Maxon, the lovely Maxon. But... And there's his Splatoon colors.
Yep. Those of you that play Splatoon that watch this channel should know what those colors represent.
Yep. Anyways, we're going to go to the next feature on all six WR100s. And that would be none other than the reception on each one.
So, Just a little side note, as I'm rearranging and wrapping up cords, because I sure as hell do not want to be stepping over cords repeatedly.
And before you step in your Apple charger like that one girl did.
No. But one thing I should note, so Mount Holly actually does something similar with the whole Sunday abbreviation thing. Instead of saying Sunday, like the bitches at Upton do, they actually say, stay out of the sunshine. Now, I think that's just a little bit better. I don't know if they do this for tide levels and, or not tide levels, surf zone forecasts. But, I know,
Upton needs to get their shit together with the stay out of the Sunday shit.
Yeah, because how do people stay out of the Sunday when we're literally filming on a goddamn Sunday?
It's Sunday! We're living in it! We're living in it!
Yeah, we're gonna fucking race it in a Texas Motor Speedway, yo!
Yep.
How are we supposed to stay out of the Sunday when we're in Sunday?
Yeah, let's not try and jump around that much, because that I just heard those things shaking.
It was this.
Yeah, let's try and not make that fall over, please. So
they won't fall over. It was the metal thing in the you know what's inside. I don't fucking know how they say it.
Well,
look at me drinking water for once.
So while Michael does that, I'm gonna go back to cleaning up and rearranging.
And while you go do that, I'm going to review the reception on each and every one of them.
Nope. Oh, drinking Miss Valerie, I see.
Mm-hmm. I drink her down real good. Wait, what?
And anyway. This is the part where I go back to my room.
Why, because the only pussy you can get is Ellie? Mr. Army Time Head Ass Look.
1356!
Eastern Daylight Time. No, literally, it says that. I'm not kidding, look. I'm not kidding.
Look. Yeah, I haven't set to do that. Because there's people that confuse Eastern Daylight and Eastern Standard Time like they're a bunch of fucking retards.
Like, but Upton doesn't say it at all.
I know, but people might look at my screensaver and say, "Ooh, it's Eastern Standard Time." So I want to show the fuckers that Standard and Daylight Time are completely fucking separate.
Let's set the record straight. From November to from early November to early March is Standard Time, but from early March after a certain date to early November is Daylight Time. Got it? You fucks. Good. Anyways, as I'm gonna slowly walk out while saying, the National Weather Service in Upton, New York has issued a flash flood warning for Fairfield County in Southern Connecticut until 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 5:01 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Anyway. The reception. We're gonna do indoor reception and outdoor reception as usual. And as Xerxes just says, just looking at me,
what do you want?
He just kissed me.
What you want? What you want, big boy? What you want, big boy? What you want? What you want? Shit, you big boy. You big boy. You're a good boy, though.
Anyway. The reception. Let's try it on the version 1 first.
Seas 3 to 4 feet. Wednesday night, southwest winds 10 to 20 knots. Seas 3 to 6 feet. Thursday, southwest winds 15 to 20.
Okay, the reception on the version 1 only seems to get better if I hold it, like the antenna.
Thursday night, southwest winds 10 to 20 knots.
Other than that, it's pretty decent. Next, the version 2. That one is better than the V1 by miles. Version 3.
Fog with visibility 1 nautical mile or less.
Version 3 is better.
Storms. Areas are fogged with visibility 1 nautical mile or less. Monday, southwest winds 10 to 20 knots.
The version 5 is much better, or the version 4. Version 5.
Monday night, west to southwest winds 10 to 20 knots. Seas 3 to 5 feet. Scattered showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, east to northeast winds less than 10 knots. Seas 3 to 5 feet. Tuesday night, south winds 5 to 10 knots, becoming 5 to 15.
Now for the V6.
South to southwest,
like to call it now.
Seas 3 to 4 feet. Wednesday night, southwest winds 10 to 20 knots.
Let's do it all together.
Seas 4 to 6 feet. Thursday, southwest winds 15 to 25 knots. Seas 3 to 6 feet. Thursday night, west to southwest winds 10 to 20 knots, becoming north to northwest 5 to 15 knots. Seas 3 to 6 feet. You are listening to NOAA's All Hazards Radio, station WXM80 in Riverhead. This broadcast originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office located on the grounds of Brookhaven National Laboratory in Upton, New York. Station WXM80 broadcasts on a frequency of 162.475 MHz. The coastal waters forecast from March is inlet to Montauk Point, New York, out 20 nautical miles.
Gotta love those Upton-style station IDs. But anyways, we've done the indoor reception on it. Now let's do the outdoor reception. And as soon as I snap my finger, we are going to be outside. In 3, 2, 1. Okay, we are back outside. And can I just say one thing? Okay. I fucking absolutely love Connecticut, but I fucking absolutely hate the goddamn dog dick sucking humidity levels here. It's bad enough I'm under a damn heat advisory because of that damn hot New England sun. But not only that, ow, the deck is actually burning my fucking feet. Ow, 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 ow. Rising heat in Connecticut, peoples. Anyways. Perfect time to be going in the pool, but wait a minute, is the water even hot? I doubt it. It actually is a little bit hot, but it's not heated, but anyways. Yeah, the humidity here sucks dog dick. No offense, Xerxes. But anyways, the outdoor reception on the WR100s from versions 1 to 5, or 1 to 6, or 1 to 69, 420, however the fuck you want to say it. But anyways, like I said, we're going to be testing it on every single radio here. So let's try it on the version 1 onward. Version 1 first. And I know I forgot to do the channel selection, but I already tried the channel selection indoors, and I could only get channel 4 in that spot. So let's do it out here instead.
And here are thunderstorms. Here is the type information.
See what I meant by the tuner being a little wonky?
743.
It works perfectly, though.
Widespread dense fog. Visibility less than 1 nautical mile. From Monday.
Also, I did notice the fucking silver paint is actually wearing down to the bare plastic on the sides, at least. But it's still a black and silver. Plus, it's from 2001. It's aging just like me. What do you expect? Anyway. So let's take a look at the reception and get back to it.
The marine forecast for Island Sound. For this afternoon, south 5 to 10 knots. Seas 1 foot or less.
There's WXJ42 in Meriden.
Winds 10 to 15.
I do not know what station that is. Can't even pick up WXM60.
High temperature.
Obviously, we can get WXM80 just fine.
Southwest winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tides, Shinnecock Inlet, high at 7:15 a.m. Low at 12:34 p.m. Sunrise, 5:33 a.m. Sunset, 8:16 p.m. For Monday, rip current risk, moderate. Surf heights, 2 to 3 feet. Thunderstorm potential, low. Little chance of thunderstorms. And thunderstorms are possible this afternoon.
WWH-33.
Mainly north and west of the Capital District. A cold front will move across the region on Monday with only... Sunday and 8:47 a.m. Monday.
12:35.
Tide is at 2:04 p.m. Sunday. Height 8:00.
Version 2 is next. What the fuck is on channel 6? Call 35, hold up.
For Wednesday, partly sunny. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. High lower 80s. Southeast winds around 10 miles per hour. And for the come off.
That's an Upton station on channel 6. Hold up. Hey, Nicholas! Are there any Upton stations on channel 6?
No, why?
Why am I hearing one on channel 6?
Well,
and it's not bleed through. I checked on the other channels, it's not bleed through. Come take a look at this. It's on the version 2.
Version 2?
Yeah.
Right.
Listen to this. Listen, this is WXM80. Okay. Here, listen to this. And like I said, it's, look, there's Coil 35, WSJ 42, WXM 80, WWH 33. Then you have this. And I know that's not WXM 80 because it wouldn't be saying it. That is so weird. Unless it's... My only theory is this. If it's actually...
It is WXM80.
That's bleed through on this thing? Oh my god, I feel like an idiot. What the fuck? Well, I'm gonna give a huge zero on reception for this piece of fuck.
Well, I mean, it is good. The reception is good. It's just so weird that it's doing that.
Yeah, in terms of bleed through, I didn't think it would be bleeding through, though. Like, what the hell? I feel like an idiot now. Thanks, version 2. Anyways. Onto the version 3.
No, the sign's at blanket.gov/deep/AQI. For the following areas in New York, Orange, Putnam, Rockland, Northern Westchester, Southern Westchester.
I am getting something on channel 2. Right here. The V1 is the best one. That's not WXM 80.
That was on channel 4, dude.
I know.
That was WXM 42, then.
Sound level ozone.
No, it wasn't.
The air quality index. The higher the A.
That's core 35.
Air quality alert.
That is up to 80.
Two pieces of shit in terms of bleed through. Anyways, now on to the V3. Alright. Feel like an idiot here, people. Thanks, 100s. Now for the version 4, or V5. Same thing.
The air quality signals both days with heat index values of around 100. Here is the official National Weather Service forecast for Southwest Connecticut. Heat advisory in effect until 8 p.m. Monday. This afternoon, sunny. Near steady temperature in the lower 90s. Southwest winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. Heat index values up to 100. Tonight, mostly clear in the evening. Official National Weather Service forecast for Eastern Long Island. Heat advisory in effect until 8 p.m. Monday. This afternoon, sunny. Near steady temperature in the upper 80s. Southwest winds 10 to 15 miles per hour. Heat index values in the upper 90s. Tonight, partly cloudy in the evening, then becoming mostly cloudy. Areas of fog. Humid with lows in the lower 70s. Southwest winds 10 to 15 miles per hour.
Version 5. Again.
With highs in the mid, partly cloudy. Lows in the upper 60s. Here is the extended forecast. Chance of rain 20%. Heat index values up to 100. Monday night, partly cloudy. Humid with lows in the lower 70s. West winds 5 to 10 miles per hour with gusts up to 20 miles per hour, becoming northwest after midnight. Tuesday, sunny. Highs in the mid 80s. Northwest winds around 5 miles per hour, becoming west around 5 miles per hour in the afternoon. Tuesday night, partly cloudy. Lows in the lower 70s. Here is the extended forecast. Wednesday, partly sunny with a chance of shifting. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration. Wednesday. Showers
and the version 6.
Sunny. Highs in the mid 80s. The marine forecast for Long Island Sound. Dense fog advisory in
highs in the lower 80s. Chance of rain 30%. Thursday night, mostly cloudy in the evening, then becoming partly cloudy. A chance of shower 79.
What's up?
95 at McKinsey, okay. 97 at Westfield, and 92 at Pittsfield, Massachusetts.
97.
It was mostly sunny, with a temperature of 92 at White Plains, 90 at Albany, 93 at Burlington, and 94 at Boston. At New York City, it was partly sunny, with a temperature of 96. Again, the 2 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time hourly information for near Northwest Connecticut. Skies ranged from sunny to mostly sunny. It was 91 at Danbury and 97 at Bradley Field. You're listening to NOAA Weather Radio WW833, the voice of the National Weather Service, broadcasting the latest weather forecasts, warnings, and other information 24 hours a day. WWH33 is brought to you with the cooperation of Litchfield County Dispatch Incorporated and the state of Connecticut. WWH33 is coming to you from a radio tower on Mohawk Mountain in Cornwall, Litchfield County, Connecticut at 162.5 megahertz and serves western Connecticut, adjacent portions of southeast New York, and the southern Berkshires. This program is provided by your National Weather Service office in Albany, New York, on the campus of the University of Albany. Now here is the hazardous weather outlook for northwestern Connecticut and Berks and Upper Bucks counties. When, from noon Sunday to 8 p.m. Monday, the heat wave may continue beyond Monday.
Now I have to say, the reception is good on every single one of them, so that is a definite plus. Apart from the damn bleed through on the versions 1 and 2 that made me look like a fucking idiot. But, anyways, on to the next feature. Or should I say problem. And this applies to any WR100 that is version 5 or over. If there even is one over version 5, but this applies to the version 5s. And that would have to be the tuner. Now this issue is not uncommon at all, especially for newer WR100s. And even newer WR300s have this same issue too, along with the 301s. Why? Simple. Because it's a version 5! And anything version 5 and over is almost guaranteed to fucking die.
I mean, unless it's a version 8, but then again.
I'm not sure about the version 8, but yeah. Anything version 5 is guaranteed to fucking die. Just like my 301.
The Furbo went off again, said Xerxes was barking.
Does it look like I'm a fucking dog to you? Furbo head ass. Anyways. So, as you saw earlier in the reception...
Want your cheese?
No, thank you.
All right.
But, as you saw earlier in the reception topic, and I just realized, where is my water bottle? Oh, wait.
If it was up your ass, you'd know.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I have the right to speak freely in my own house.
Bitch. Anyways. Here's the thing. About the tuners. As you saw earlier when I was covering the reception, I was picking up WWH33 on this thing, the newer version 5 or the version 6. And as it said in the station ID, WWH33 is broadcasting from Cornwall Mountain. I mean, Mohawk Mountain. In Mohawk, Connecticut, on Cornwall Mountain. Anyways, from Mohawk Mountain in Cornwall, Connecticut. Brought to you from the National Weather Service office in Albany. From the campus of Albany. We did it! But anyways, here's the thing about the tuners. The tuners in the version 5s, as soon as the version 5s started to come out, the version 4s and down did not have this problem. Not until the version 5 came out. As soon as the version 5 came out, they introduced a brand new, cheaper tuner. That ruined everything for the V5s. Because most of the reasons why the V5 WR100s or 300s die so much is because of those damn accursed tuners. It's like a time bomb, a ticking time bomb that's about to explode.
Because they probably use a cheap crystal oscillator for that tuner.
Exactly. Whereas on the older versions, they still work perfectly because it's actually better quality. From versions 1 through 4.
But the good thing about the tuners, even if they die, you can find them for cheap on eBay.
If you have some electronics experience. Because you need a soldering iron for that. But the tuners in the V1, V2, V3, and V4, I know this is a V5 anyway, but I'm just going to do it anyway because it fucking works. 12. Work just fine. But the V5's an over? Forget it. They have the ticking time bomb tuners. These three radios have the three fucking ticking time bomb tuners. And you know what's worse? I don't know if you know this, Nicholas, but this is Javier's V5, right? And when he had this in his possession, there were times where it actually did the high-pitched squeal and just went back to normal.
Oh.
You didn't know that, did you?
I did not. How did you...
He told me that.
Well, shit.
You did not know about that, did you?
I did not, but I'm just thankful that it's working.
Yeah.
There have been times where it, like, hasn't activated, but that's the only real issue I've been having with it.
Imagine if the fucking tuner went to the high-pitched squeal every time it received it. You know what? Let's test that fucking theory. Let's test that motherfucking theory.
It went to the high-pitched squeal every time what?
Every time it receives an EAS header. Let's test that fucking theory.
Well, it activated for the weekly test last week.
Well, that's true, but... Oh, balls.
Works better when you plug it in. Do you want me to... On a serious note, though, do you want me to make you a sandwich or something?
Nah, I'm alright. Thank you, though.
Alright.
And this is not gonna work.
That's what she said.
Okay. Fuck off. Anyways.
Tell me to fuck off in my own house. Alright.
Well, I mean, it's your private place. You do it in your room anytime.
Beesh. I'm gonna have my lunch. After.
Okay. Anyways, let's try and self-activate it. Well, we know it doesn't do that thing I was predicting or fear. Theorizing. I don't know how to say it. Theorizing, I guess. That failed miserably, but anyways, we know it, we're not trying to self-activate it for the siren test or anything, because we already did that earlier, and I'm pretty sure that all of you know exactly what the fuck they sound like. But anyways, well, it doesn't do that theory, but that's the problem with these newer 100s and 300s. It's the tuners. If it wasn't for that one tuner that they used in these newer V5s, and the V5s in general, it could have been good, like, it could have been bulletproof, like the versions 1 through 4, but no! Because of the newer version, they decided to be different! And different they were. In terms of fucking reliability. I don't want to be too unfair on this radio, because it's a legendary product. But the fucking tuner just kills its reliability. Once that tuner dies... It's done. Tell that to my dead 301, which I still have yet to replayer. Replace and or repair. There you go, dummy. Anyways. We're going on to the next feature on this radio, or these radios, I should say, and that is going to be the build quality from... 1 to 5 or to 6. Whatever you want. By the way, EAS buddy, fuck you. This is just for you, buddy. Fuck you and seethe with rage at the sight of 6 WR100s. Read it and weep. Ring-a-ding-ding! Or, if your version 5 just so happens to completely die on you, just take a look at what this girl did and see if you can follow suit.
You see this damage? Guess what?
All right, the build quality on every single WR100. Obviously, they are all very good radios. In terms of, you know, reliability for the older versions, the newer versions to some extent, but it's very limited. But anyways, the build quality on these radios are very, very good. Sure, they have some wear and tear here and there like the black and silver does. Like, even though the black and silver's paint is starting to, like, fade away to the bare plastic on the sides right here, which I'm pretty sure Nicholas has noticed already. Because of the black and silver on the faceplate, on the silver side, it's wearing down to the bare plastic.
That's not good.
Like, I don't know if you know that, noticed it, but yeah. I heard Gibby from iCarly, didn't I?
Yes.
Anyways, the version 1's build quality is immaculately good. Superior quality. Same thing with the V2. All these radios really have great design and build quality.
It's just the V5s that supposedly have
built. National Laboratory in Upton, New York.
Stations they're doing the ID at the bottom of the hour.
On a frequency of 162.475 megahertz.
But yeah, version 3 is good. V4, even though it's a V5, same thing. As I've said a bunch of times already.
I think Carson has a V4, if I remember correctly.
He does. Version 4/5. This is basically a newer version 5, like the latest version 5 you can buy from like 2011, with the version 9 serial number, like the 9 on the front, the first digit on the serial number. But it's funny how it evolved from the black and silver to white.
There is a version 2 black and silver and a white version 1, but
yeah, there is.
Which Michael actually passed up a white version 1.
I don't want a white version 1. I want a version 1 this.
Why? Does black and silver not work for you, you fucking racist?
No, I want a version 1 this. I want a black and silver version 1. That's the true V1.
Racist.
Not the V1 white. I don't want the white.
Racist.
How am I racist when I'm fucking white? Yeah, it says the white head ass over the albino abominable snowman bitch.
You bitch.
Is that why you drink so much water? You wanted to freeze up inside of you so you can rebuild your fucking strenuous dick?
Maybe to freeze my soul, but...
That's my job. That's my fucking job. Anyways,
I thought your job was to fuck Valerie, but alright.
Fuck me like Nicholas fucks Ellie in the pipe!
bitch. You bitch.
I know I am.
You know what? You know what?
Just don't do any public masturbation, you fucking freak.
I'm not like the neighbors, bitch. But, yeah, you know what? You know what?
You're gonna lean over and fall over, weren't you?
No. What black and silver? What?
I know you have my black and silver.
I don't.
I saw you running down with something.
I don't.
I saw you running down with something black in your hand.
That could be anything, you fucking racist.
Alright, you know what? If I'm really racist, then where's my black and silver?
I don't have it.
Yes, you do. It's not on the counter with the other. Without with the
I don't
other
have
versions.
It.
Yes, you do.
Search me. I don't have it.
It's in your bag, isn't it?
Well, who said it was? What? What?
Either
what?
That or it's in your bed.
It's nowhere.
I know you have it.
I do.
Where is it?
I don't know. It's not up there. I just got in there.
That's what she said. It's not over there with the CFC. Nope, those are your... Why the fuck are you wearing jeans in the summertime? How are you not hot in those?
Cold. Cold.
What do you...
Cold.
Oh, we're doing this shit.
Warm. Warmer. Cold. Warmer. Warmer. Hot.
I know.
Hot. I know. Hot. You're hot! You're on fire, baby!
I knew you had it. It wasn't your bag. You bitch.
Okay, this is actually a new feature that has never been seen before on radio reviews that we're going to discuss with all of them. And that's going to be the evolution on each version. All right, the last feature that we're going to discuss, because guess what's on? Kyle Bitch at Texas Motor Speedway in the NASCAR Cup Series. It's about to start at 3 p.m. T-minus 10 minutes. But anyways, we're going to discuss the evolution of each version. So, on the version 1, as you know, obvious difference between the 1 and the 2, which is the color difference, although they did make version 1s in the white color. Same thing with the version 2s. They did black and silver version 2s, but this is a white version 2. But the black and silver version 2s are basically the same thing as the version 1, and they're basically the same thing, except they have a port on the side for the external alert, but we'll get to that in a minute. So, here's the version 1. No external alert port. Obvious color difference right there. You got a warning, watch, and statement light on the upper right-hand corner, along with a silver Midland logo and a NOAA logo. The backlight is obviously pretty dim for its age. It has a silver weather snooze button, black buttons as usual,
On the side, you have your weather radio on-off switch. On the back, you have these two handy flip-up feet. Which can be really handy in terms of adjustments. And it takes three AA batteries, which are not included with the radio when you purchase it firsthand. Oh, yeah, thank you. And I see you're holding the WX268.
Which is using a thing of freaking chapstick to hold up the screen because, yeah, the hinges on it busted.
Let's see that. No, let it go. No, hold it level. There you, let it go. Anyways, on to the version 2 now. The version 2 is identical to the version 1, but somewhat different, mostly different in terms of color and appearance, and firmware as well. So, here's the version 2. It's obviously a nice white color. On the side, you have the external alert port, which you can plug in a strobe light to it. It has your weather radio on-off switch on the side. Wow, I have never seen this before. Nicholas, I have never seen this before. The weather on-off switch is worn out.
Yes.
I have never seen that before. I've never seen that before.
This is on the,
The 2. I have never seen this before. This is so weird. But anyways, obviously it has an external alert, like I said already. The backlight is a little bit better. It has the same watch layout and design as the black and silver, except it has a black weather snooze button and a black NOAA and Midland logo. It still has black letters like the black and silver does. On the back, it still has the flip-up feet. And it still comes with three batteries, which are still not included. By the way, it does help that the version 2 actually has the label still stuck on the back compared to the black and silver. Nicholas!
Well, sorry.
Bitch. Anyway. The version 3 is obviously very different now. The letters have gotten bolder on the bottom on the version 2. And it carries on with the version 3. Because in the black and silver, you can see that they are not, you know, bold. And same is not abbreviated on the black and silver. It is on the version 2. But I think only the later version 2s. But here's the version 3 now. Carries all the other features in from the version 2. External alert port right there. If it'll focus. There we go. Weather on-off switch on the side. Backlight is better. The addition of the alert test feature still has the old style NOAA logo, but they replaced the watch and advisory statement lights. Instead of it being yellow and green, it's orange and yellowish green now. Plus, they added a public alert logo on the upper left-hand corner, because if you didn't notice before, the versions 1 and 2 don't have a public alert logo. The version 3 introduced that. On the bottom, you still have the flip-up feet, as expected, and it still comes with, well, not comes with, but powered by three AA batteries for backup. Again, V3. Now on to the version 4, even though it's really a version 5. There's not really much to say, although the version 4, I think, had a slightly different NOAA Weather Radio logo on it. It still had the same light layout. But instead of saying Hazard Alert Monitor on the bottom like it did on the version 3s, 2s, and 1s, there are some variants of the version 3, I think, that say Public Alert Monitor instead of Hazard Alert Monitor. I'll put a link to that in the description so you can see it. Oh, I still need to show you that video, Nicholas, but anyway... Starting with the version 4s and up, they changed the bottom text to say SAME Digital Weather, All Hazards Alert Radio, instead of Hazard Alert Monitor. So, this applies to the V5s as well. The version 5s and 4s don't really have that much of a difference to them. They're all basically the same thing, Except the version 5 has those crappy tuners. But the version 4 still had the good ones. But nevertheless, there's no, visually, there's no difference between the two of them. Unless you look really hard. It is what she said. But one thing I will say, the version 5s have the, or at least the latest version 5s, like the newer models, have the new style NOAA logo. Because I have two version 5s at home. And the older version 5, which I got from a thrift shop, and by the way, the fucking tuner on that thing is already going to shit. Yeah. Thanks, Midland. But anyways, it's not entirely Midland's fault, but oh, actually it is. Because they were the ones who put the tuner in. But also, it's Age's fault. Because Age can do a lot of shit to electronics. As demonstrated in the past. But anyways, some of the older version 5s have the old style NOAA logo. Not this old style. It says, it'll say all hazards and all that, I think. But yeah. Actually, no, it is the old style, I think. Yeah, it is. But,
besides that,
there's really not much difference between them all. So, that's that. Actually, this just came to mind. This is that the last feature that I, even though I said the evolution of it was the last feature, it's not, because this just came to mind. There's actually an accessory made by Midland for them to sell for the 300s and the 100s too, because they can work on the 100s. So, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the Midland 18 STR strobe light. Now, you're probably wondering, what the hell does this thing do? Well, remember that external alert port on the side? And see how the strobe light has a 3.5 inch... Or, I'm sorry, wow! Nicholas, 3.5 millimeters is now 3.5 inch, according to my stupid ass! And he'd be spanking Ellie like crazy. But anyways, 3.5 millimeter jack. And it'll actually flash when it receives an alert for those who have hearing impairments. For those that are hearing impaired. So, oh, see? Oh, wow. See? As I'm plugging in. By the way, for those of you who have problems with flashing lights, I advise you to look away from this video immediately. But, see, as I'm plugging it into the thing, I'm barely even plugging it in, the strobe light is actually already powered on. Just like this. But it flashes like that whenever it receives an alert. Or when you do the alert test. So, if I go ahead and do the alert test on the version 3, this happens. And it applies to all the other versions, too. Here's the version 5. Or the version 4, whatever. The other V5. And the last V5. Very, very useful feature. Running Snail did the same thing with the frickin' the 319? Yeah, the MD-319. They did the same thing, except they included the strobe light for free. But you have to pay $20 or something to fucking, you know. Yeah, because Nilla decided to be ass one. Yep, and guys, I'm just going to have it on the audio only. Because we're about to go racing here at Texas. Let's take a listen.
Raceway Ministries offers today's invocation.
Oh, hey! And Nicholas's dad just arrived as I was about to film the thing. So, anyways, now we're done with the features.
So, in conclusion, on the WR100s, ranging from versions 1 to 5, this is, what's there to say about the final thoughts? This thing is an absolutely legendary radio, and you need to get one because they are very cheap, they're common to get, they're not rare at all except for the black and silvers and the version 2s. Version 3s, maybe, but the version 5s are the most common ones that you can get. They're all built well, they don't fail too often, even though they have wonky tuners. My man! Anyways. They're doing the national anthem. But anyways, guys, as Texas Motor Speedway is about to start, get the WR100. As long as it's working fine. So, without further ado, guys, I'm gonna go watch Texas. So, thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for future videos like this. Also, subscribe to ThunderBuddy01 and subscribe to everybody in the description below, including Miss VR, NorCalDude599, Derpy Fire Alarms, basically anybody who contributed to the radio reviews episodes in some way possible. So, I'm gonna get out my NASCAR diecasts, root for Martin Truex Jr., and we're ready to go racing, boys! See you next time, guys! Thank you.